Hello and welcome to Unkie Gaming. This is Unkiejay here. Today I'm back in Feed the Beast Unleashed in Minecraft, and this is my house. So in the last video we looked at solar panels and things like that. Since then I've actually made a second solar array because the first one wasn't enough to power my machines. I've got more machines. And now got two macerators and two furnaces. They're usually working all the time. And I've now installed MFE, which is just like a bat box but better. The bat box I think holds 4,000 power, and this one holds 600,000. Wow. There. I built the MFE. It wasn't actually too hard to build. It's just gold cables, which is just rubber and gold. And an energy crystal, which is just redstone surrounding a diamond. And a machine block, which is all super easy. So I've got that now. I never ran out of energy. I'll probably put in some more machines soon. So I can get a better production line going. I've also gone into Thorncraft a bit more, and I've researched this, thormium. Thormium is a result of fusing base metals with raw magic energy. The resulting metal is a metal harder than iron, with the ability to accept enchantments beyond that which iron is normally capable of. And you can make a whole bunch of things. You can make a sword, pickaxe, axe, shovel, hoe, and also the armor. So I've actually gone ahead and already made some of the armor. I made these two pieces. Put it on. And to make it is really simple, actually. All you have to do is throw these things into a crucible, so it's linked with metal and magic power. So you can do iron ingots and like vis crystals or something. Or you can just use force ingots, which I've got a ton of now because I went mining like all day. Well, not all day, I just went for a few hours. I put a crucible down in my mountain where our first house was before we started building a house. I was going to put it in my house, but you need to have a heat source underneath the crucible. Oh, I think I need a bucket. I do. You need to put a heat source under the crucible, and I didn't want to do that inside my house because my whole house is made of wood. So that wasn't going to work. You also need to fill the crucible up with water, which is what I forgot to get, a bucket. I'll just get one now. I had my portal going there, but I've left my portal in a cave, really. I think it's about 2,000 meters away from the house. So I'm just leaving it there for now in case I need to go back and mine, because I was in this massive mine shaft and I was mining there for, I don't know, hours. And I still hadn't even done half of the mine yet, so I just left it there. I should put a door here. Okay, so there it is. Lava underneath the crucible. Let's put some water in there. Can I put more than one bucket? I don't know. Oh shit. No, I can't. Okay, and so all I do is throw things in. That happens. I don't know how much I can throw in. I'm just gonna throw in a bit. And then I just hit it with the staff. There we go. And that made 6 thormium ingots. I don't know if you throw more things in, if you get more items. Oh, I gotta wait for it to boil. There we go. We'll just throw the rest of these in. And There we go, got 5. I'm pretty sure doing this Thorncraft stuff makes the area get bad aura, which has its own set of problems. So that's kind of annoying. I've noticed wisps have been hanging around like heaps. There's always like some around, I'm like, oh, I think that's my fault. And now everyone's wishing they'd live next to me. Now we go through here. Go downstairs. And let's make some Thormian tools. Actually, I have some here too. 15. Now, I don't know if this is better than diamond. I don't think it is. It could be though. Let's just make one more of everything. And an axe, because why not? There we go. Thormian tools. Let's put that the buckets away. Done. I always have a diamond one on me just in case. I need to get diamond. I mean, netherrack. Obsidian. I don't know if Thormian can do it. Maybe it can. Is that redstone? Why do I have redstone in there? In case I had to like start making blocks of things because I was running out of room. And I've got 2 blocks of iron, 2 stacks of it. That's like 64 stacks of iron. Actually, 9 stacks of 64. Yeah, 9 stacks. And I've done the same with redstone, gold, because I was just running out of room. So we got that. But today, what I'm going to do is start with this power armor. It's like a really good armor set that you can put enhancements on it. You can get like night vision for the helmet, jumping, flying. So I'm gonna start doing all that. It looks really good. So Blake was mining in his mountain today, and he got emerald. So I was like, please, can I just have one emerald? Because I knew I needed it for this. So there we go. Let's start with that. Refined iron. Redstone. I think I have a circuit here. Yay! I know I need a lot of refined iron, so what I'm gonna do is look at all that. I'm just gonna refine some iron. Refine a lot of iron. Not any to sleep. So yeah, we're gonna be doing that. Making this tinker box, I think it's called. I need the emerald. And I need a machine block, which is just 8. Refined iron in the square. There we go. There. And there. Power armor tinker box. Should I put it down here? I'm gonna put it in my room. Yeah. I'm gonna wish I put it there. So I'm gonna have to keep going back and forth a bit. And I'll just put it here. There we go. No modular power suit items found in inventory. Make some. So let's get to making some power suit armor. Now if I want them red, there's 2 ways of making it. There's refined iron. And there was another way. And normal iron with wiring. This way seems a lot easier. because electronic circuits, you need all that. But with wiring, it's just gold cables and redstone. It looks really easy. So I will be doing the easy way. Let's get some gold. It's gold this time, not force ingots. Gold, redstone. What was the other thing? Iron. Okay. So we need to make some of these. Make 36 for now. Can you make gold pressure plates? Oh, weighted ones. I never knew that. When was it like that? Wiring. 36 wires. And then it's just iron ingots. Okay, that looks pretty easy. Do the boots first, because I remember that one. Oh, is that not working? Why doesn't that work? That was one way. Boots. Fuck, I already forgot. Three iron at the top. Wiring, wiring. Helmet. What's that? Fan? What is that for? Chest piece and leggings, three at the top, two down the bottom. 1, 2, 3, 2. There we go. We have the whole suit. That was so easy. Now this is the hard part. You've got to make the enhancements, or else it's just a piece of crap armor. So these are all the things you need. I've never actually made it properly. Slow water, which can later be used to cool yourself in emergency situations. Mob repulsor, pushing mobs away from you when activated, but constantly drains power. Cools down heat producing modules quicker. Active camouflage, emit a hologram of your surroundings to make yourself. I think that just makes you invisible. Generates a magnetic field strong enough to attract items towards a player. This module drains power continuously. Turn it off when not needed. Parachute adds a parachute to slow descent. Activates by pressing shift in midair. Tack on some wings to turn downward into forward momentum. Press sneaking forward while falling to activate. That seems pretty cool. I've never actually made any of this, so you'll have to bear with me. Heatsink. Well, that's pretty cool. And I think the more stuff you have, the heavier you are, so the slower you walk, and the more energy it uses. So, do I need to make this stuff? Which can still release massive amounts of energy. I don't know. Maybe I should just start with the low one. So I think I have to like make each piece. Ugh, that's gonna take a while. Much lighter than plating but consume energy. So I would probably go with, we'll start with all the basic stuff first, I guess. With the helmet, I really want this night vision. So it always gives you night vision, it's pretty good. Flight control, an integrated control circuit to help you fly better. A compass on the run, oh, I don't need that. Connect up some thematic goggles to show nearby aura values. Does not reveal aura nodes, only shows in a HUD. That's pretty cool. Lets you write to your HUD via opening for peripheral bridge, and a computer craft computer. Oh, I haven't done any computer craft stuff yet. You've decided to take that ability into your own hands. So, night vision is definitely something I'm going to get. Control circuit, and hologram emitter. So, I think I need to make those two things. Whenever you're hungry, this module will grab the bottom leftmost food item from your inventory and feed it to you, storing the rest for later. That's pretty cool. Solar generator lets the sun power your adventures. That's pretty cool. Oh, there's so much stuff I need to get now. Generate power with your movement. Oh wow. Oh, this makes it so you don't have to walk upstairs. Walk up a block. You can just walk. You don't have to jump up step blocks. Swim boost, jump assist, sprint assist. Jet boots, not as strong as a jetpack, but they should at least be strong enough to counteract gravity. Shock absorbers with some sort of spring cutting. You should be able to negate a portion of fall damage. Well, there's some pretty cool stuff that I want to get. Let's start with the helmet. We'll do night vision, so hologram emitter and control circuit. Hopefully. Oh, cool. So, wiring. Do I have cactus green? I don't have glowstone. And what was the other one? Emitter or something? Let's get back into this. Control circuit. Controller circuit? No, control circuit. Glowstone dust again. Wow, I'm gonna have to go to the nether. Let's see if there's anything I can make without glowstone. So batteries, plating, we'll do iron plating, battery plating, battery plating, ion thruster. Glowstone again. Is that what I want? That's it. So I can definitely make this. Invar gear. I don't think I found any Invar. I need glowstone. Well, I will start building all of this very soon. I'm gonna have to go to the nether first. Looks like I have to do that before I can do anything. So, in the meantime, I will make an armor stand for my armor that I can't wear. Because I'm pretty sure it has a less rating than what I've got on now. Yeah, it does. Because it's got no attachments. Armor stand, 2 iron and 3 stone slabs. And there. I love these armor stands. And then we'll put it right here. Wow. That looks insane. Oh, I love this texture pack. Well, that will be what I'm wearing once I go to the nether. So in the next video, I'm definitely going to go to nether. Okay. So this has been Unkiejay from unkiegaming.com. Thanks for watching. Make sure you like the video if you do enjoy watching it. And I'll see you next time. Bye!